How's it going, everyone? My name is Sam. I want to go over Bitcoin's price action right now because we're getting a very bullish trend right now, and we've seen this throughout the day. Now, over the last couple days and over the last really week or two, I've been talking about this bearish narrative that has been coming out in crypto and how I think a lot of it's manipulation by people that are in command, that pe by people that are whales that are trying to buy more of Bitcoin. Everything has led to it. Everything has been showing us that is the case. Now, today we are seeing a massive pump up in price. So let's take a look at the chart here. We have this massive green candlestick, which is right after Elon Musk tweeted something about Bitcoin. We'll hit on that in a second. But we're seeing a nice price increase. Now we're seeing it stabilize right around this $39,000 mark. We had a little bit of resistance around 40,000, almost touching it, but stopping a little bit short. Now, if we look at the 4 hours, this is quite interesting. It's a really good sign in my opinion. If we just look at the bearish trend that we had here, we had it continuously hit these peaks here, five different peaks that it hit, and today we broke through that. We broke right through that on the upside, and we're seeing a nice uptrend. Now, we have had some positive news throughout the day before we even got this most recent price increase. We had news this morning from Ray Dalio on CoinDesk talking about how he would rather hold Bitcoin than bonds and how he actually holds some Bitcoin himself. If you don't know who he is the largest asset manager out there, $138 billion worth of assets under management, and he regularly outperforms the market. He's someone that a lot of people respect a lot. Now, in addition to that, we had this news come just a few hours ago. US Congress will not pass cryptocurrency legislation anytime soon. So this is coming from Jim Hines, and he said the crypto legislation is not expected from Congress anytime soon. Most of my colleagues don't have a deep understanding of cryptocurrencies, what they can do and what the dangers are. Congress has not spent a lot of time on it. So for better or worse, there's not going to be legislation passed out of the United States Congress anytime soon. Now, this is talking about that fear, uncertainty, and doubt last week, where we were hearing that they were going to make us record transactions of $10,000 or more between businesses in the crypto space. Now, this doesn't really strike me as odd anyways that they would do this, because this is just similar to everything else that they have. They just want to get paid, and they want to get tax revenue. So I totally understand them wanting this to actually be sent in and for people to have to pay taxes on this. Now, there's going to be some fear and uncertainty and doubt into the future, but it seems like there is this more bullish narrative recently, and we can see that a lot of people are excited that Michael Saylor and Elon Musk have recently been tweeting about Bitcoin mining. So Elon Musk tweeted out, spoke with North American Bitcoin miners. They committed to publish current and planned renewable usage and to ask miners WW to do so, so worldwide to do so, potentially promising. Michael Saylor said, "Yesterday, I was pleased to host a meeting between Elon Musk and the leading Bitcoin miners in North America. The miners have agreed to form the Bitcoin Mining Council to promote energy usage transparency and accelerate sustainability initiatives worldwide." So that's pretty big. He goes through some of the companies: Argo Blockchain, BlockCap, Core Scientific, Galaxy Digital, Hive Blockchain, Hut Mining, Marathon, Riot. So overall, there are a lot of big names there. They say were present and decided to publish an organization to standardize energy reporting, pursue industry ESG goals, and educate and grow the marketplace. Now, this is huge. This is huge for Bitcoin mining, and obviously, people were very excited about this, thinking, okay, maybe there isn't going to be a massive problem with energy. Maybe Elon Musk can come and save us all, and Michael Saylor can come and save us all. Now, overall, I think this was bound to happen, right? Did we expect them not to figure something out? Do we expect Elon just to sit on the sidelines? He's talked very positively about cryptocurrency and says he would much prefer to the fiat system we have now. So I think it's pretty obvious that he was going to do something like this. I talked about how he was going to get into Bitcoin mining himself, possibly. So whether he is the one that is actually mining it, or whether he's just talking to all these other miners and somehow you know, maybe they sell them some products or they help them on the backside with some contracts. I don't know exactly what they would do yet, but it's pretty interesting that he is kind of leading the way with Michael Saylor to bring all these different companies together and to make sure that we are mining in the best way possible. There have been a lot of articles recently on China FUD too, talking about how China wasn't going to allow Bitcoin mining anymore, or they were going to crack down on it, which a lot of people were actually excited about because it would further push this other side of the world to, you know, continue to mine sustainably or to go more green. And on this side of the country, or on this side of the world, we do mine in a different way. We're not using as much coal as China. So that would overall increase profitability and help the environment if China stopped mining so much Bitcoin. Now, of course, I'm not a financial advisor. I'm not an analyst. I'm not a crypto expert or anything like that. But it is interesting to see how the tides have turned, definitely. Just in a few days, how we were at peak fear yesterday with Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Cardano all at really low lows, right? We saw them all pressuring or pushing down on that support level. And honestly, I've been picking up a lot over the last couple of weeks. I was excited yesterday, and we are seeing a nice bullish trend. Now, I'm not saying that we have not seen that in the past, but over the last couple of weeks, we have seen mostly negative, just a really bad trend here, but we're starting to break out a little bit. Now, whether we actually stabilize around this $40,000 mark, I would not be surprised if we did, because we have seen some supports here around $38,000 before. I would not be surprised if it continued to go up. I mean, we've seen whales continuously adding to their portfolios and taking Bitcoin away from newer wallets. We've also seen whales manipulating, right? They bought Bitcoin and then they coordinated and sold it off all around the same time and caused the price to drop. And then they went and bought all the cheap Bitcoin that they could at those lower levels. Now, we could always see that in the future. This is still not an asset that's very regulated. This is still something that's easy to manipulate because of the size of it. But we are seeing this positive catalyst overall and this more positive narrative. Now, we've seen Ethereum push up too. We've seen it push up over 2,600. BNB, which was in the 220s, I want to say yesterday, is up significantly to 342 today. I picked up a couple of those yesterday. And then Cardano is up almost to 160. So we are in a good situation. Of course, please do your research. Don't give in to the FUD. Don't give in to the manipulation. Please watch people that are in the know. If you guys want to subscribe to this channel, I try to always bring the best content possible, and I'm not trying to fearmonger anyone at all. I'm just trying to bring to you guys what is happening in the market, and hopefully that helps some people out. Thank you guys for checking out the links down below to Webull and to BlockFi. If you guys want some free stocks, you can check out the link down below to Webull. Just deposit $100 to get those free stocks. And BlockFi gives you a bonus and an interest rate when you sign up. Thank you, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.